finished both of these books. I read this one first, and then this. I can't remember which one was supposed to come first. So I think that the Ice Fire was supposed to come first, and that is the one I read first, was Ice Fire. I cannot get this camera right. Anyways, so I just finished Quicksilver. And I will read to you what, you know, the back of it. The place, the Pentagon, headquarters of the U.S. Department of Defense, the world's most safeguarded and secure building. The event, an unprecedented gathering at which the military leaders of America and Europe are welcomed into NATO, its most controversial new member, Russia. The nightmare, in breathtakingly precise split-second operation, a team of ruthless commandos takes over America's ultimate military command post from the inside. Within minutes, their hostages include the top military officials of more than 20 European stations, along with America's senior military commanders, the Vice President, the First Lady, and the Joint Chiefs of Staff. The stakes. Higher than even the president can anticipate, because the enemy commandos also seize control over top secret orbital weapon codenamed Quicksilver, powerful enough to decimate America and change the balance of power in the world forever. And then it says, a warp speed techno thriller with the most engaging underdog protagonist since Jurassic Park. This follow-up to Reeve Stevens' best-selling Ice Fire ensures their entree to the techno thriller elite. Okay, now, remember how I was saying that James Rollins books in the back have information on what is fiction and what is fact? Okay, so in this one, I didn't really find it in the Ice Fire unless somehow I missed it. But in this one, back in the acknowledgments, it says, once again, we have benefited from the knowledge and experience of many people who know the reality of things we write about. We trust they will be entertained by the fictional uses to which we have put their factual input. So, this one goes through with some acknowledgments. It's not as clear as the James Rollins book, the way that it's broke down, but like I showed you in the back. James Rollins is just, he's amazing. But a lot of these have a lot of factual stuff that actually could happen or could be going on, and it makes you think. And a lot of times it makes you think, see, that everything's not black and white. I don't know. I thought this was good. And I thought the Ice Fire was good. Now I'm reading, what am I reading? Anyways, it's something having to do with conspiracy of history and religious relics and stuff. The thing with the books like that is I study religion and such, and the more I study religion, the more I realize how many deaths, how many wars, how much just bad stuff has come out of religion. And it's like, wow. You know, like the Illuminati and the Catholic Church and all this kind of stuff. And it goes back through every religion, these books, and how the, I mean, it's just, and the thing is, that's reality on how it had, oh boy. And it makes me more and more think, wow. look, I did a blue dye on top, but it makes me really look at things like, wow. But I will do a book review on that one when I'm done. The stripe was bugging me. All right, so like I said, this was Quicksilver on this one. The authors Judith and Garfield Reed Stevens. And then, you know, you have this other one. Yep, so this one first, and then this one. I suggest it, that they're worth reading. So go out and give it a shot. All right. See you guys later for the next book review.